Okay. So lately I've been seeing the exact same question all over YouTube, all over Facebook. Where is a good place to buy a budget lightsaber? Now what if I told you you can get a lightsaber that looks like this and sound like this for under 200 bucks? Let's check it out. What is going on, you guys? It's Chris, aka the Nerd Dad, and I realize it's been over a month since the last time I posted a video, even a review or any of the Star Wars stuff that we buy and just go bankrupt because it costs a lot of money to do. Now, the reason of the video, like I said, a lot of these sabers get very, very expensive, and I looked into this company for quite some time. My buddy Sam over at Absolute Sabers, he swears by these lightsabers. I just couldn't figure out what was so great about it. What was the hype? I couldn't figure it out, so I bought one. I bought one for myself, and I'm telling you right now, they're $170. Blade included, and I think in pounds, like 130 pounds, somewhere around there. I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure it's 130 pounds. Now, if you guys are brand new to custom lightsabers, this is an excellent option for you guys. So if you guys are not aware, a lot of custom lightsabers have soundboards located inside a lightsaber, which is essentially the brain of the lightsaber, and that is what makes it function the way it does. You may see some crazy videos of the blade do some crazy things. That is because it has a custom board in there. Now, out there, there is Profi board, CFX, Golden Harvest. Profi is just top tier. To me, I believe it's top tier, but it is a little difficult to learn, and there is a learning curve to it. Now, if you are new to custom lightsabers, this is such a great opportunity for you to dip your feet into them because this is a great option. Now, this is one I got from Padawan Outpost. This video is about Padawan Outpost and my experience with them, and I will tell you right now, it is 100% positive. Now, Xenopixel board does so much. It does just like almost exactly what CFX boards do and Profi boards. It's just a lot cheaper, and they do a lot of stuff that you'd be surprised what it does for the price. It's crazy. It's crazy. Now, I am gonna go over a couple things with this lightsaber so you newbies can understand what it is that I'm talking about, what it is and that they do and how they work, all that fun stuff. Now, at the very top of the lightsaber, there is what's called a retention screw. This one actually has two retention screws. The retention screws is meant for the blade to enter inside the lightsaber itself, and once it goes in, you use those retention screws to tighten in that blade so the blade doesn't fly and hit your mom. Or your kid. Or your dog. But make sure you tighten it nice and tight, that way it doesn't fly out and hit your TV, which I've seen that happen before. Now, on the lightsaber itself, it does have the activation button, which is going to be located right in the center of the lightsaber with a USB-C port, which is going to charge your saber. It's nice because USB-C is faster than the standard USBs and stuff like that. It's just a lot better, and now a lot of companies moving over to USB-C. It's just a lot faster, and it's actually better, especially for file transfers. Located in the bottom of the lightsaber, you're going to have the pommel. Now, the pommel is the bottom end of the lightsaber. It has 13 holes in the bottom to allow sound to come out of the actual hilt itself. Now, on the inside, now, a lot of custom sabers all come apart so you can access the board. Now, the board always comes with a micro SD card. This one actually comes with a 16 gigabyte board. Once you unscrew it, it'll unveil the Xenopixel board along with the 16 gigabyte micro SD card. On the opposite side, you will get the actual 18650 rechargeable battery that's located in the very back. The 18650 battery, I don't know if it's removable. It looks like it's removable, but I'm not gonna go in there and pull it out. I'm not gonna pull it out because I don't wanna break it. I don't wanna risk it. And it's just not gonna be a good time. So I'm not gonna do it. But there's no point in removing it because you had that rechargeable port right in the center. Like I said, it is USB-C, so it's gonna be a lot faster charge. The bottom end of the actual saber itself, you're going to see the 24 millimeter speaker. It's actually decently loud for what you get for it. A lot of us like 28 millimeter speakers. I personally like 28 millimeter speakers. They just sound a lot better, a little bassier too, but I personally just like it. And like I said, the bottom does have that vented pommel. That way allows all that sound to come out. Now, I'm not gonna go over the actual basics of the lightsaber, how it works. I will go through a couple things. The great thing about this, it comes with, I believe, 6 different blade styles, and it comes with different ignitions. Now, blade styles, basically, it's just how the blade is going to react when it's on. Some is gonna have more of a strobe effect. Some will have more a unstable, for instance, like Kylo Ren's, it's gonna have that look. And some, like the strobe one, is blinding. Like, I thought I was going blind because the thing was so powerful. Now, the different activations and how they turn on, you're gonna see, I will show you a couple of them, how they actually work and how they look. You'll get 6 activations, you'll get 6 different blade styles, but you will also get a ton of fonts. And what are fonts? You guys might be asking yourself, what are fonts? Now, a font basically is the actual sound coming out of the lightsaber. There are a lot of people out there who make their own fonts, and it sounds just like the ones from the movies. Kyber Phonic, K-Sith. There's a bunch of people out there who make them, and they're pretty damn good at it to where it actually sounds better than the movie itself, and you really feel like a Jedi. Or Sith. Or whatever. I mean, you feel just like it. There's even a Thor and a Pikachu one out there. It's crazy because people make some incredible, incredible saber fonts out there. And I mean, this one is packed with over 34 different ones. It's crazy how many you get. So think about it like this. Your basic font goes for $7.99. Okay, times 30. How much is that? Terrible at math. No idea. $239. It's $239. I spent $170 on this lightsaber alone. So you're getting a huge, huge deal with just these fonts. You're gonna get the lightsaber itself, you're gonna get the Xenopixel board in there, you're gonna get all these fonts, and this thing's incredible. Now, if you guys don't know what smooth swing is, because you guys have been living under a rock, or you just don't know, because when I first got into this hobby, I had no idea what smooth swing was. Let me show you. All right, so your basic Black Series lightsabers that you'll see at GameStop and Amazon, stuff like that, you're gonna see those. This is one of them. This is a Black Series lightsaber. You know, I'm gonna say this is actually the first type of lightsaber I ever got in 2008 was an FX lightsaber, which was the sabers came out before Black Series, but they went out of business, the Master Replica ones. Those of you who know what it is, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Now, those were, but I actually have an upgraded one. So if you guys haven't seen the upgraded version of it, I have one. I will link that down below so you guys can see it, because what a huge difference that actually makes. But a good example of exactly what smooth swing isn't. Because this doesn't have it. So you can see just how sensitive my hand is when I go like this. There's nothing. You can't, unless I swing harder. See that? Now watch. Nothing really. It's kind of but that is what smooth swing is not. So that is what old technology is. A lot of these soundboards, Xenopixel, CFX, Prophet, all have smooth swing. Now if you wanna know what smooth swing is, let me show you. Okay, so the cool thing about this, it has what's called gesture control. So you twist it and it actually turns on. You don't even have to press the button, okay? Now, it's nice because the button does have a nice illuminated red on there, which is pretty cool, a nice little accent on there. I'm personally not a fan on it, but this saber, actually the purpose why I got it was so I can teach myself how to swing. Not really teach myself, because I have to watch a whole bunch of pros do it, like Carly King and the man himself, Stony Magnum. I can't do any of that because I'm pretty sure I'm gonna knock myself in the head, but I bought this for the purpose of being able to learn, because it's just totally smooth and it's, you don't have stuff in the way. You'll see when you get your own custom sabers. You get Canon sabers. Some of them just aren't great for spin. With this, you get what's called twist on. And you can see just the sound difference between the Black Series one compared to this. Now that's smooth swing. Sick, right? Sick. And then you get what's twist off. The cool thing about these is just you can do so much. Now, I remember in the movies how, like, stormtroopers would shoot at a Jedi, and the Jedi would just, pew, you know, blast or deflects, right? It has that. So every time you turn it on, and you press this one little button, sick, right? So, like, those don't have that. This has it. If you hold it, turns it off. Easy. Now, another cool thing about this is when you hold the button and you clash, or basically what a clash is, one of those, just like, the response on this is incredible. Sometimes on my Prophet Sabers, I don't even get a good response like that. Normally it's wherever the actual board is located, but this one's located at the bottom and I still get really, really, really good response from a Xenopixel board. Now, if I hold the button and you clash, now it does have that sound of two Jedi or Sith actually colliding together, and it causes this really, really cool effect. Now, like I said, it does come with different blade styles. So let me see if I can find one that's a different blade style. Let's see. Okay, so I found one that has a different ignition. So this is one of the six that you'll get. So instead of a simple just, you know, scrolling effect that goes all the way through the actual blade itself, you get one of these. So you can see just how cool and awesome that is. You get so many different effects with these. I believe you get a blade one, you get that blinding freaking strobe one. Now, mind you, if you guys are sensitive to light in that sense, be very, very careful. Me personally, I'm not gonna do it because there are people out there who are very, very sensitive to light, and I'm not gonna do that to you guys. I'm not gonna have you let you guys have a bad day because it's just not worth it. So don't do it. Now, I did order this lightsaber on a Tuesday, I believe, and literally less than a week later, I actually got it in my hands. Mind you, Padawan Outpost is located in the UK. They are a family-run business in the UK, and it's pretty incredible that I actually ordered it, and less than a week, I got it. Now, the weird, strange thing is the fact that I got the blade 3 days after receiving the actual lightsaber itself. Kind of weird. I'm not sure what happened. I don't think that's the fault of Padawan Outpost. I think it was actually DHL, because DHL does tend to have issues like that sometimes. And I think it was them. I don't think it's Padawan. I don't blame them because I don't think it was them. I'm standing by that. Now, with the lightsaber, you get this nice little custom box right in here. It's pretty, basic box. But the nice thing about the box inside, you do get the actual hex key itself. You get the instructions on how to actually use the lightsaber. And probably the coolest thing about this lightsaber you get is you actually get a mini SD card reader. Who does that? Most times you have to go buy your own, or I have a little adapter that goes to my computer that I can plug all my stuff in. But it gives you the SD card so we can plug it in and you can change your fonts, you can buy different fonts. Now, I believe K-Sith and Kyberphonic do have Xenopixel fonts that, like, when you buy it, it tells you if it's Xenopixel compatible. So that's something you definitely want to make sure that it is compatible with Xenopixel boards. But I believe K-Sith and Kyberphonic do have that option for you. Now, I'm not going to go through the whole, putting in fonts and stuff like that for a Xenopixel board, because that's actually a little bit too much. And for me to put all that in this video, it's just not going to work out. So what I'm going to do is I am going to tag my buddy, Sam, right down in the description below to his tutorial to how you can actually add fonts to a Xenopixel board. Now, if you guys are looking to buy from Padawan Outpost, I will link in the description down below to where you guys can get one from them. Now, they are a very, very busy company. Like, there are times when I, before I actually bought one, I tried to buy one, and they're out of stock, and you just couldn't get them. But they do give you real time on their Instagram account, I'll link that down below, to where you guys can actually know when they're going to restock. It'll tell you 10 days, 5 days, and stuff like that. So you know when they're going to actually restock. Now, all their lightsabers are LGT sabers. LGT lightsabers are basically just Chinese manufactured ones, which the majority of these are a lot of Chinese anyways. A lot of them come like this, where you can just, get a basic Xenopixel. They do offer Profi as well. And the other cool thing is they're Canon lightsabers. Some of those are extremely incredible. I hope to one day get one for myself, because you guys know me, I am huge with Canon lightsabers, and personally, that's my favorite. Now, if you guys aren't already subscribed to the channel, guys, please subscribe. Helps me out. Just right down there, do it right there. It literally takes like 2 seconds to do. Now, I am at 450 subscribers, 50 more away from the 500 mark, you guys, and I am giving away that Boba Fett helmet that you guys saw on my last video. If you guys didn't see it on my last video, I will link it down below, or put a card somewhere up here to where you guys can see it, because it's been sitting in the box. I'm just very excited to actually just be able to ship this out and give it to one of you lucky subscribers. Now, if you guys aren't already following me on Instagram or TikTok, guys, I'm on TikTok now. It took me a little while to actually get on the TikTok train, but I will link that down below to where you guys can follow me there as well, because why not? Why don't you? Because I put real-time updates to things I'm doing or games that are coming out and stuff like that, because if you guys saw my other TikTok, I am going to Star Wars Celebration. I am so excited to go to Star Wars Celebration. I get to go hang out with a bunch of these content creators that you see us do on live chats, mainly on Sam, Absolute Sabers YouTube channel. Normally, that's what we do. We're always on there. But I'm so excited to do that, excited to meet up with my friends and be nerds for 4 days. And it's in London. I've never been to London, so let's just hope my camera doesn't get stolen in London like it did at Disneyland. Sad. That about covers this review, guys. I am super excited the way this actually came out. It is a great option for any of you guys looking for a budget lightsaber. Shout out to Padawan Outpost, because this is an amazing product. You guys shipped this to my house clear across the other side of the country in less than a week. Who does that? Which is pretty incredible. I can't really say anything about their customer service or how good their customer service is, because I didn't have to deal with them at all. Like, I put my order in, I got my order. Yeah, my blade came in a couple days later, but I did get a notification that I was getting something else, and to me, I was like, well, it's probably going to be the blade. And it was the blade. Now, the blade did come at 36 inches. I was kind of hoping I had an option to change that, and you don't. I'm wondering if Padawan Outpost is going to give you the option in the future to where you can get a 34 or 32 or 30, just because I'm not very tall. I'm actually a pretty short person, so 36 inches does not sound great to me. You know what I mean. Now, mind you guys, I'm giving a huge shout out to Padawan Outpost. Does not mean that they sent this to me. I bought it with my own money. I will show you the receipt. I won't do that actually. But I did buy it with my own money, and I am extremely happy with it. And thank you. So with that being said, you guys, I hope you guys have a great day, and may the force be with you.